Dear friends, my name is Vladislav Shevchenko, and you are on the ATAS Trading Platform channel. In this video, we will analyze the imbalance footprint chart, interpret information about buyers and sellers' disbalances, and make trading decisions. A little disclaimer, trading in the financial markets has a high risk exposure and your actions can result in a loss of financial funds. The information in this video is for introductory purposes only and is directed at presentation of the ATAS platform functionality. A bit of theory. Markets move up looking for new sellers and down looking for new buyers. Sooner or later, one of the groups proves to be wrong and makes losses, while the other side makes profit. Imbalance footprint shows predominance of buyers and sellers. Sells and buys are compared diagonally, and if a set percentage predominance is detected, clusters are highlighted in red or green. By the way, you can load this template from the list of standard templates in the chart settings. It is called imbalance. You can also set the disbalance percentage ratio in the chart settings, cluster settings section at the bottom. In our example, we use 200% predominance on the oil futures with the CL ticker. In this video, I will use two main ideas when analyzing imbalance charts: pushing the price along a trend by sellers or buyers, sellers trap after decrease or buyers trap after increase. You should also remember that we, as discretionary traders, do not aim at catching absolutely all movements and getting 100% of profitable trades. Our aim is to find the most clear situations and use them for making a trading decision. For better performance, we will add the stacked imbalances indicator, which will duplicate double imbalances on the nearest prices with the 200% predominance. So let's start. We have the delta chart with 150 contracts. This chart type envisages that a candle is closed when its delta is 150 or minus 150 contracts, and a new candle is started being built. This chart type should help us in identifying buyers and sellers' disbalances. We see the local growth and identify the closest support area. The three marked imbalances are sellers. The price moved up. At the moment, it is a sign of the fact that sellers got stuck and buyers gained a local victory. The best opportunities arise during reversals, that is why let's wait for the situation to develop. We see an aggressive reaction of sellers after some time. The pricing impulse moves down and we get new sellers imbalances. It is important for me that the price moved below these clusters, which emphasized domination of sells over buys. At this moment, I am placing limit orders at stacked imbalances levels and entering with a sell market order on a little rollback in case the price doesn't return up and goes down straight away. The price is traded in the profit area for some time. You can take a part of profit in this area, but I give the price a chance to move down and increase the profit. However, it doesn't happen this way. The dynamics started to change and the price started to enter the loss area more often. Two more sell orders are executed, and I still give this trade a chance. A buy imbalance appears on top of the bar, and I move the stop beyond it. If the price moves higher, it will be not interesting for me to stay in this trade anymore. All conditions for down movement have been created, and we just have to wait. An important thing – red imbalance levels serve as local resistance areas. There were sells, and if we move up and consolidate on top, I will decide that sellers got into a trap, and this situation becomes a reversal into a long position for me. Unfortunately, the market turns out to be stronger than me in this situation with sells. I had several opportunities to partially exit from selling below and take a part of profit, but I overlooked this opportunity because my expectations were high. I accept the loss and continue to trade. As I've already mentioned before, reaching the stop loss will be a strong sign of the upward reversal for me. I mark disbalance levels, and now I have sellers in this area who got stuck. It means that I want to buy at these levels. I mark them with horizontal lines for a better view. I place buy limit orders and a stop loss below the area with the sellers who got stuck. The price stays for some time in the area of the imbalance, which is the closest one to the buy trade. I take the upper imbalance of the seller as the first goal. Earlier, he reversed the price, and perhaps there can be a stop. In the future, I will be able to adjust my take profit, but at the moment I am placing it just in case the price reaches this level very fast and I fail to exit manually. The price continues to move up a bit later. The reversal gains momentum, and we receive a new buyer's imbalance. Now this is a new level, and the price should consolidate above these clusters for confirmation of the buy strength. I close a part of the buy, since this disbalance slightly resembles seller stop losses. And as I've already said at the beginning of the video, the intraday price often moves from some stop losses to others. I move my stop to the zone below the support area and continue to wait for development. There are no reversal signs yet, and the buyer controls the situation. A new stable buyer's level is formed, and the price cannot break it down. I move the protective order yet higher beyond the new area. The price continues to move up, and the profit grows in this trade. New buyer's imbalances appear at the previous high breakout level. It's a dangerous area for a buyer, and there can be a reversal. That is why I move the protective order yet higher beyond the new support area. The buyer gets through after a small fight, and one more upward impulse takes place. Note the nature of this movement. There are zeros in the footprint left column, which means that sellers didn't even manage to sell in time. It's a clear sign of activation of seller stop losses, since it's necessary to buy out a loss-making position in order to close loss-making sales. I move the protective order even higher, because the price has started to move below buyer's imbalances. The second part of the buy is closed. The seller failed to overtake the initiative after some time. All his efforts broke against the support area. There's a buyer's imbalance, which pushed the price up, at the bottom of the current candle. It serves as a trigger for one more buy in continuation of the current uptrend. I mark the closest support area, place buy orders, buy a part with a market order, and place a stop loss beyond the buyer's imbalance and support area. The price executes the second contract in this trade. I place a take profit with one contract at the risk-reward ratio 1:1. The aim is to remove a risk from this trade. However, the buyer still cannot win, and a single buyer's imbalance, which forms the resistance level, appears. I place a take profit on it in one pot. The price continues to increase, the take profit is activated, and new buyer's imbalances, after which the price continues to increase, take place. It's a clear sign of the buyer's support, so I move the stop loss beyond this area. There's an effort to continue the growth, but the buyer is denied. The price breaks the nearest support level and closes the second buy part at the break-even point. I get reversal signs at the moment of breakout, and this is a chance to execute a short-term sell trade. I place limit orders at the seller's imbalance levels. The price executes only one limit order out of three ones and quickly moves into the profit area. A new resistance area is being formed, which allows me to remove the remaining orders and move the stop loss in break-even beyond this area. I wait for some time, but this sell doesn't develop further. So, I place a take profit of the only contract at the seller's imbalance level, which is very similar to activation of buyer's stop losses. The risk of reversal increases again. That is why I exit with a profit which I managed to make. Drawing a conclusion, I want to express my hope that we managed to clearly show the usefulness of the imbalance footprint. You will be able to develop your skills if you practice every day, monitor the price behavior, and take note of reliable patterns. Remember that practice is the cornerstone of success in understanding the market. Share this video and press the like button if you liked it. Ask your questions in the comments and see you in our next videos.